pop up.
My name is Starr. I go by Auntie Starr. I'm a DJ. I'm from Lancaster, California. I recently moved to New York not too long ago. And I would say a fun fact about me is every country I've been to, I've got a tattoo in, so it's kind of cool.
My name is KeyOne. I'm from the Bronx, New York. Fun fact about me is my birthday is the same birthday as Lil B, so I'm based. I'm a student of the game. I've been studying this hip-hop for like pretty much my whole life since I was like... changed because obviously back then you guys had to cut records and it was like the whole vinyls getting records at the stores, and now like technology like just made it easier for DJs.
I feel like there's an element of authenticity and like grit back then that we're almost like missing out on.
They had a role in like making an artist known and like helping them get out there. Now I don't really see too much of that now. So.
Yo, I don't know none of this shit. Yo, wait. What the
messenger.
Fuck? I'm just. Wait, where am I? Jazzy. What the fuck, yo?
Ali Shahi.
Okay. Yo, you're a connoisseur. I need a class. Clearly.
Forget it.
The energy that you're trying to bring, you need to be able to adjust.
Like you said, you could play like the best records, you could play, it doesn't matter when you play it, it's like what time you play it, like you gotta play it at the right time, the way it hits, and everybody can feel it, you know? So, Marley Marl, like that era, like Marley Marl and like MC Shan, I think, and with BDP, like he got with KRS, and like that's how they got like the whole like Bronx to get known. And that was dope.
Like, Splendor really, 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 like, made it possible to be like, yo, you can do this and be good as fuck and be fire and still be going on tour, still be like, you know what I mean? You don't have to, like, compromise. Like, you don't have to compromise on the basis of being a woman to be good at a certain thing. Like, hip-hop isn't only for men. And I feel like for a long time it was, like, going in that direction. So... it's dope. Now we can actually expect like women to be on the lineup. You know what I mean? Like now it's a problem. Like, yo, if you don't have a woman on this lineup, it's like, why? Like there's so many fire women DJs now. And like, we definitely have to shout out Spinner for that. Like, disc jockey.
Scratching, of course.
Come on, we know. Scratching. It's like a really good way of like finding yourself in the music. Like it's like a nice way to like really find like where you want to drop the next track.
Like, I think it was scratching. Like I'm not a big fan of it, but it's definitely like important to know how to scratch. But it's like sometimes like DJs be overdoing it. Like just let the song play. Like It's like you gotta know when to cue like the song, like what part of the song, and like to like blend it in, like transition it with the next song. So it's pretty dope, like how like you can create your own kind of like style within scratching. So, but it's pretty much a program that DJs use to mix.
They also make equipment, like that's a lot of the controllers you'll see would probably be Serato. Like they have so much good equipment too, and like that's not even including the software, like you were touching on, like, and being able to like DJ only through the software, and then you add the equipment and you can like go even further. Those are just like folders that you can store and like put your music in different playlists, like just put them in different crates and like be able to be like, all right, I want to tap into this one. Do you use them?
Yeah, I use crates.
One and two, is like one turntable to two.
Pretty much, like
yeah, right. Oh wait, for real?
Yeah, I mean, it has to be.
Yeah.
Flex night.
Yeah, it's cool.
Hard to get a ticket for Funk Master Flex night.
Trying to like host people and just like play music. I mean, like in high school and stuff, when me and my friends would like just be being bad and like home when one of our parents isn't home, we'd like all be bumping music and I would always be the person playing the music, whether it was just like on my laptop or like on my phone, like with the grossest of transitions now that like looking back, right? Even if like we're all just chilling, like I want to play black background music and I like have the vibe for that already, or like, oh, we're about to smoke, that I got the whole 420 playlist ready. But it wasn't until college that I was like, oh, I want to just like buy a controller. So I ended up like buying this like, I think it was like $200 like Serato controller. It's like the DDJ SB2. And I've just been DJing on that for a few years up until moving to New York, where I've like went to this like CDJ workshop and I learned how to like DJ on CDJs, which was like really, really cool. But really the root of it all is just like loving to like see people react to like what I'm playing, like, oh, that's my shit. Like, that's my favorite. It's my favorite line like ever. Like, so like, oh, this is my shit. I'm like, yes, bitch, this is my shit. Like, this is yes. Like that's really why. I just feel like music just makes people happy. And like, to be the one being like, okay, let me, ooh, y'all not ready for this, let me blend that, and like, the reactions, really cool.
My dad is a DJ, so it was like, at first, I'm not gonna lie, like, it was always all around me, the equipment was there, turntables. I always loved music, it just didn't really hit me until like, I'd say 2014, like my senior year of high school. My uncle, he has a show, like, he does online, so I became a part of the show, and I was just doing that. And I was just getting people in the school to tune in. I started taking it serious, like I'd say around like 2016. Like, from there, I just been like, kept pushing. I love the reaction. I just love music, like, and it's just it's pretty much like, everything she said is pretty much why I love to be like playing music. When I just play a tune and it's like, yo, what you know about this? I was like, what you know about this? Like, that's my favorite reaction. Like.
I'm Auntie Starr. You're just tuned in to Get Hip. You can follow me on Instagram, Twitter. I lie. I don't even be on Twitter like that. But you can still follow me on Instagram, Star Profits, StarProphets. You can also check us out on Half Moon BK. Lovely, lovely underground DIY, open platform, radio station. Thank you all for having me.
All right, follow me on Instagram, KeyUno, KeyUno _.
Without the DJ, there's no party. Without the DJ, hip-hop would just not exist. Disc jockeys played a large role in the blossoming of hip-hop culture. While their importance has fluctuated, their impact has continued to reign supreme. DJs traditionally decide what gets played in the club, on the radio, and in the street. With the music industry embracing the digital age and streaming, DJs have the opportunity to reclaim the position as the gatekeepers of sound. If you didn't know, now you do. Get hit.
Pop, pop.